if we don't care about water quality problems at the source, they just turn into bigger water quality problems downstream. And that poses human health risks. Increased nitrate concentrations can cause blue baby syndrome in infants, and in adults it can be linked to increasing incidence of thyroid disease and colorectal cancer. So we have to solve these problems. So we're trying to develop new approaches for understanding where water quality problems are originating in agricultural watersheds. Some parts of the watershed can be disproportionately important. We think if we can identify those regions, we can come up with more efficient ways to use conservation programs to solve those problems, or at least reduce them. The traditional approach for monitoring water quality is to set up a bunch of equipment at one fixed location and monitor continuously through time at one fixed point in space. And so what we've done is we've taken that monitoring platform, and instead of sticking it on the side of a stream bank, we're putting it in a small raft and we're floating down the stream with a GPS unit attached. And that allows us to make spatial maps of water quality in the middle of the stream network to understand better where water quality problems are coming up. I like to describe this project really simply as we take $50,000 worth of science and put it in a $50 cooler, put that in a $500 boat, and then go out and make these maps. The data sets that we've been able to collect with that sampling platform are akin to what it would take 5 to 10 times that amount of resources to do with the old kind of fixed location monitoring strategy. You can measure a lot of things, but we've started our investigation focusing on nitrate because in the Upper Mississippi River Basin, it's a pervasive contaminant in agricultural watersheds. And so what we've seen with monitoring nitrate throughout these watersheds from the pack raft is that there are some tributaries in these streams that are consistently more concentrated in terms of the nitrate they're sending downstream, others that are less concentrated. And we wouldn't have necessarily predicted that based on a land use map alone. So we now know that there's something unique about those ditches or those other tributaries, and that gives us ideas about what things to try next. Things to try next would be to increase our monitoring of those ditches and tributaries, looking at more detailed land use history information to see if we can understand what's causing that part of the landscape to behave differently. And if it's a part of the landscape that is giving us cleaner water than typical, then we want to try to identify that so we can maybe emulate it elsewhere. And if it's a part of the landscape that's giving more nutrients than its neighbors, then we know that that might be a place to target more effective conservation practices.